बट आज हम लोग बात करने वाले हैं कि एक शादीशुदा कपल किस तरह से मतलब अपना सीन करके एक आर्ट्स कलेक्टिव फिल्म प्रोडक्शन सर्विस लाइक व्हाट व्हाट डू यू कॉल इट लाइक व्हाट इज दिस व्हाट इज मिया बिवी एग्जैक्टली
इट्स अ मैरिज सेविंग डिवाइस नो आई थिंक फॉर अस इट वाज अ गुड वे ऑफ बिकॉज़ वी हैव सच सेपरेट करियर्स व्हिच कैन बी रियली बिजी कैन कीप अस वेरी बिजी ऑन आवर ओन this felt like a good way to find a way of doing something together, doing something creative, making some money together, and yeah.
For the music video floated by, वो तुम्हारी actual शादी थी?
Yes.
Like that was your तुम फेरे ले रहे हो, you're legit taking feres and that's being recorded as a part of the music video for the band.
Yeah.
What
did
you take it again for the video?
Well, we did. It was kind of a plan to make something out of it, but we weren't sure what's going to happen. So,
okay.
Yeah.
There was a guy in my band, Karthik Pillai, whose brother is Sachin Pillai, who's actually a cinematographer based out of Mumbai.
Mm-hmm.
Who does a lot of work there, in ads and music videos and stuff. So he was obviously coming to the wedding because he's a very good friend of ours.
Right.
And we asked him if he wanted to film the wedding, and you know, instead of like a classic wedding, like after wedding film, we thought we'd make it. And so, I mean, we saw all the footage he did, and it was so nice. Most of the footage in that video is basically him.
Right.
You know, like 90% of the footage is his. And then we had a new album coming out, and then the wedding sort of fed everything. It gave us a visual aesthetic, an idea, music videos, naam sham, sari photos.
And also I think, so the wedding we, Suryakant and I did all by ourselves.
Huh.
We did everything for
so
the
not
wedding.
The way typical Indian parents' weddings go about, right?
Yeah.
Parivar baat karte hain and then card badhte hain.
Oh, no. I mean, obviously that didn't happen in any case because we had been living together before we got married and our parents have been like part of our relationship for many years.
Right.
No, but in terms of also just, we didn't siphon off, which maybe was not such a good idea, siphon off any responsibility. So from the production to like the art direction to like our clothes, guests, everything we did together. And I think that also formed a good foundation for Miya Biwi because we went through the whole rigmarole of doing everything, right? Like from logistics to the creative part to like running the show to also getting married.
Paying for it. So it's like
So budgeting, finance.
Yeah. So basically it's a big like it's like a big production essentially our wedding for us. And you know, paisa vasool karna hai, so we made a video music video and art out of it and yeah, so it's like a really interesting, weird, kind of philosophically, I don't know, what's the word when it's...
Serendipitous?
No, it's another word. It's
eclectic?
No, like, not eclectic. It's sort of a... The word will come back later to me. There's a... It's a... Shit. Can't
what are you trying to say?
You know, it's... well, if I knew the word, I'd tell you exactly.
No, but like the description of it.
The description is...
It serves many purposes. But it's all—it's like life affirming. I don't know. Like, what are we looking at in this word salad in your mind?
Shit, I just can't.
Okay, fuck the word. We'll get to it later.
Anyway, it was like he said, I was essentially the
litmus test.
The litmus test of our relationship and ability to work. And it was the first real project for Miya Biwi, literally the wedding of us. So,
in the Indian contemporary, socially, upwardly mobile, जो एक Indian है, जो middle class है, जो How I Met Your Mother type की चीजें देखता है, but suit सलवार में भी interest रखता है उस type का, like it's a very mixed identity. Roman anglicized शब्दों के अंदर उसको ऐसे लिख देना मियां बीवी, that appeals to a lot of people, especially the Instagram aesthetic generation, right? That we're a part of. Has this name like invoked reactions? I like what do you guys looked at as in the industry, if at all there is?
I don't know. I mean, we aren't really part of the industry. We're sort of a outside force, you know. And that's not something we really thought about in terms of. Well, we did think about it. It would be a nice like phrase. It would be. It's a nice. The words look nice together. Mm-hmm. It's simple to say. It doesn't sound like over the top. It's honest. That's it. I think we just think like that. There's no like...
I mean, and also I think to me, you know, like you're saying this, choosing to have like a name that's in another language, written mm-hmm. in English, but it's Urdu, right? Miya
right.
Biwi. I think it also represents sort of like our aesthetic slash generation, which is perhaps one of the first generations that is proudly combining our sort of Eastern and Western influences and upbringing.
Mm-hmm.
Because I think previously, at least when I was growing up in the 90s, for instance, like if you didn't, for instance, speak English very well within a certain socioeconomic group, it was, you know, that's a simple way of explaining how we gave so much more importance to perhaps Western ideas and Western thinking. You know, that was considered
yeah.
like cooler, and we didn't sort of go
literally
back
like to... this is my theme for the next 2 months. Is I've been going around talking to people about the exact same thing. Ki yaar tum Hindi mein bolo, koi scene nahi hai. Ye jo idea hai na, ye socially ki log tumhe judge karenge ki tum English mein bol nahi rahi hai. Tumhe South Delhi ki ek cool club ke andar ek entry mil jayegi aise
yeah.
karke. Ye scene nahi hota.
And I think people are becoming more comfortable now with that idea that, you know, English doesn't necessarily represent education or
mm.
intelligence, which is, I think, sort of what it was mistakenly
right.
seen as earlier. So that's yeah, that's sort of part of why I think Miya Biwi is also representative of just our
mm.
aesthetic. And then I think the other thing is it's also very personal.
Mm.
And that's something that we were fairly clear about early on, that if we do work together, it has to be about who, how we perceive the world or who we are, because otherwise it's just any production house that's making things for the client. And you know, the plan wasn't to make like, and it still isn't, to have like Miya Biwi as our full-time career, because we do have individual careers, so that also enables us to create a space for ourselves where this is like about how we would do it or how we see it, and not necessarily like us doing something for you the way you want us to do it.
Hmm.
Yeah. Of course, there's a push and pull with clients. But
because I saw the Raw Mango campaigns that you guys did, and I was surprised. There was a very, I'm not a French cinema cinephile person, but I've watched my fair share of French cinema in college, and I noticed there's a very... French aesthetic to a very Indian setting. I think that's the best way I can describe it. Probably I don't want to butcher what great piece of art you've created with my words, but like how do you guys go about creating that? And
which
what
one?
The there was Heer, and then there's also Suti, is that right?
Yeah,
right. So I mean, I guess like Suti, because that was really interesting.
Yeah, they all had very different processes, but like at least in Raw Mango, the guy who owns it, Sanjay Garg, he's been like a huge part of like that process,
right.
especially the Raw Mango films, and also a part helping us like start working together, because Heer, for example, is where me and Surabhi like for the first time actually did some work together.
Just the both of us.
Just the two of us, you know. So we shot that, we did the recorded music and all this stuff, and then we sat down and Sanjay and us tried to figure out how to make these films, and they did well. And then I think by the time it came to Suti, we'd already done another couple of campaigns with him. He gave us a little more
creative freedom,
yeah, where he pretty much just brought us along with him and said jo karna karo. And
I think that like with Sanjay though, that's been the process even for Radha, and he,
yeah, it quickly like changed.
Yeah. Like he sort of will set the aesthetic definitely, because Patiala was going to the Neemrana in Patiala, or like going to Vrindavan, were things that he decided.
Mm-hmm.
But then within those spaces, he kind of says, okay, now you guys do what you want.
Right.
And that's, yeah, it's like this organic.
And the music, did you independently produce music
yeah.
for all of that? Because I heard...
Well, it's for Suti, all of it I wrote.
Mm-hmm.
Which is just like harmonium, really.
Right.
And then the other two, what we did is like, we actually... Sanjay and us hired like musical groups, local musical
mm-hmm.
groups, like in Heer, there's like a couple of local musicians, Punjabi musicians came, and we literally sat in a hotel room and asked them to play some songs,
mm-hmm.
And I recorded them. And then the same thing happened for Radha, where
right.
you know, to Holi, so we got got some people to come play some holy songs.
And the guy who says the small monologue about Vrindavan as well, that was all part of
everything
that
is record. Well. All the audio except for maybe one or two tracks which we got off YouTube after we contacted the person who played them is all recorded there. So the interesting thing about those films is they're very self-contained. That like, you know, especially, well, most, not all of the music is there, but a lot of the sound, a lot of the music is recorded when we go to the to the location of where we're doing the shoot, which is a really, really interesting thing to do, and like it also makes the film seem more real and more more authentic. That's the word. That's the goddamn word I'm thinking. Okay. Sorry.
Like, you've been doing this stuff for a while now, about a year or so, right? What are you trying to achieve with this, if at all, or is this like a passion project?
It's like a passion project.
No, it's not a passion project.
No.
But you said it is a passion project?
Yeah, because I think when we started, it wasn't like, we didn't have a specific goal ki we'll be like millionaire, we'll make a 10 crore company. There was no plan like that. We said, okay, we'll start working together. This works. And then as it's growing, obviously we're getting more and more work and it's becoming a more like serious.
Yeah, that's why I wouldn't say it's a passion project anymore, because it's obviously now starting to come together and quite quickly like a company. But I think, yeah, what I wanted to say is what we probably never foresaw. What we didn't see coming was, I think with a lot of couples, for instance, like when you're working together, there's no separation of the personal and professional, which there isn't with us either. Of course, we fight a lot, like while working and otherwise. But I think what was surprising was that like our sense of aesthetics really match. So usually, and that is what is really important when you're making a film. Even when it comes to the house, for example, right? Like if there's a corner that we're setting up, it usually becomes a very collaborative process. Like if I do something and Surikant will add something, we sort of like what we're adding. Yeah. So that kind of works, and it works very well with, when you're making films, obviously, because then there's, you know, you're never fighting over like the look of it. Maybe you're fighting over like small bits or technical details, but you both kind of agree that this is the direction the film could take, or this is the aesthetic it could have.
So the personal chemistry definitely translates into like more professional chemistry in terms of, you know, you working on the
film. I feel that's almost the best part about it.
Although personally we dress very different.
Yeah, I mean,
personally we have different aesthetics, but
in certain ways they are different. But yeah, I think like that's what's working, is that actually there's a real chemistry, there's like an intense background. There's like, it's just not just dhanda basically. There's obviously like this, like meta is the word. Yes, alright.
So meta as in like M-E-T-A wala meta, ya meta buddha?
M-E-T-A. Yeah, that's meta. I was
what is the context?
The wedding. I was still trying to come up with the word. Yeah, basically the wedding video was an extremely meta meta video, obviously.
I love how your brain just processed that for 20 minutes. I said,
smoker's brain. Takes like 20 minutes to remember.
It's a hyper meta video.
Acha.
Yeah, wedding ho rahi hai, yehi ho raha hai, it's real, then it's...
I mean, clearly, you know, this is very interesting. I was sitting in Boston and I told my friends, hey, I want to play this band for you, and played Peter Gat recording Go, right? And then I played the video for Where the Money Flows. So till the point where you don't have the video on the TV, right? Where the music stops for a little bit. Everyone said, yeah, this is like a band from the 60s, 70s, right? And they were like, this seems like a new video. When I told them this is a band from New Delhi and this has all been made in New Delhi, they lost their minds. So, you know, like, and then I like sort of like, you know, can take credit for like spreading that to like four people who I knew in Boston. But it's interesting is that they responded to it similarly to something that they would respond to, let's say, if it was made in France or, you know, any of the more, I guess, bibliophile sort of, you know, novel aesthetic traditions of looking at film. And I wonder, is that because of you know, your time in France, or is it because, like, what is it? Is it a fusion of your time in Delhi? Like, help me unpack that.
It's all of it. No? It's like, I also studied film, so there was like a lot of little structures formed there. You know, like aesthetic structures, how to construct a film, things like that, and then watching films together, and like also doing everything is sort of educational in our life, I think, you know, even the raw
mango. You're both self-taught in terms of the cinematography, direction, all.
Well, me, obviously not to a degree. I basically in film school, I learned a lot of the pre-production aspects of film and a bit of editing.
Right.
But I never got to like actually directing anything, or you know, I made some films myself, but they were very like abstract student films, you know, like artsy shit, which made no sense. Doors ka gana chal raha hai.
Oh, yeah.
Yes,
I know exactly.
Basically, like that's the, you know, that, that's the classic.
Or psychedelic culture se introduced ho gaya ki kya baat hai, door chal raha hai.
Yeah, yeah.
Profanity aa rahi hai. Char paanch ladke bole dorm mein, ha bro.
Yes, exactly. You know, so obviously I was not happy with that. That was like definitely not what I wanted to do. I was like, this is like mindless. It's kind of soulless. It doesn't appeal. Other than being kind of pretty looking, it has no reality or truth of its own, any depth. So.
Yeah, and I think like, I mean, what I was saying earlier, and then I forgot the second point of what I wanted to say, which is come back to me now. When I was saying that, you know, when I was saying that we are part of a generation that is sort of comfortable moving between Eastern and Western sort of references and upbringing, it's not that, of course, generations in India have not done that, but I think they've done, like a lot of them have done that, pivoting off like this fusion, right? It's always like a fusion of Western and Eastern identity. And I think what is different about what we do, what a lot of people in our generation sort of do, is that it is a seamless mix which makes it international, which is what like your sort of little anecdote also represents.
Right.
But I think that what we're making is sort of universally appealing to people with a certain sense of aesthetics. They can be from everywhere. It like transgresses, you know, geography essentially.
Right.
It's going into philosophy. It's not going into like, you know, like necessarily. At least these particular set of films, they're philosophical films. They like money flows and stuff. Is it has no relevance other than the moment that the whole Modi sequence begins.
Right.
That's why we also did it a monkey face, to remove like a cultural identity up to a point. You know, like obviously a monkey is not Indian or black or like white or whatever. So. That's, I think that's what the universality of it will.
When you're saying that, I'm thinking of, you know, since you're talking about the mask, I'm thinking of the Guy Fawkes mask from Ideas Are Bulletproof, that whole idea, right? He's basically, even if...
V for Vendetta.
Yeah, V for Vendetta, that's the film, thank you. Because I think that that film also translates to multiple people across the globe.
Yeah.
Versus if it's just an Indian face, what's going to happen, at least what I think, if I speculate, is that someone from abroad will see it and see it as something exotic, and then they would have to, I guess, you know, spend more of their senses trying to figure out the meaning. But if you strip the content of its aesthetic and localized parts, you still have the philosophy alive, right?
Yeah.
So I mean, if we can, you know, sort of go in that meta zone, like what is the philosophy for Miya Biwi? Because you both are still figuring stuff out, right? And then fusing that and channeling that into Miya Biwi, so
what is the philosophy of Miya Biwi? How to get rich.
That's the philosophy.
That's a great sonic branding, by the way.
That's the philosophy. I think we're experimenting with what a marriage can be.
Literally what I was going to say.
Yeah, I think.
That I think it's like also a personal
experiment.
Right.
You know, like.
Yeah, because very often it can get like much harder to work together, because we're also like screaming and shouting as like husband and wife with each other, right? Like even if it's a simple thing like make an edit change, it's not just edit change, it's like you didn't make the edit change and you didn't do the fucking laundry either, you know, like that will sort of like constantly cross we'll cross wires like that. So it is definitely,
and a lot of our videos are documenting our life together in some weird way, you know. So that also works out like that. Like Floated By obviously is a wedding video.
Or like We're Getting Married.
That's obviously, well, yeah.
All
About Us again. And then there's also that Peter Gat Copulations.
Right.
Which is two dogs. Which is also actually, I shot that on our holiday together to Goa. Uh-huh. And she's the one who suggested looking at the dogs. Look, they look like lovers. And then it clicked. Or I'm Home, obviously she became that chick at the end. I don't know if you've seen these videos.
I haven't seen the I'm Home. I haven't seen compilations. I've seen the other.
Yeah, so those two videos are also, they also have her in some form, and then it's just, it, like I said, it's sort of, we are experiment. We are almost like a reality TV show, I guess.
I got it. Real life is inspiration. Is that a cheesy tagline?
What, blurring the lines between truth and
right. truth. Yeah. Documenting my every single day, you know. Yeah.
Yeah, I don't know what we're doing here.
I think, but no, like that's,
I think that's a great answer.
That,
yeah,
but that is like sort of with Miya Biwi. It is that, like, we were discussing this a little earlier. It is literally like we would like to do something based, or whatever it is that we're doing should be based kind of like on our life or life experiences or who we are.
Yeah.
Like, it's, that's kind of what it is.
And that's,
it's
a documentary background plays into it, where it's like, you know, I'm bringing like the whole arty shit of things, and she, from that side of things, she brings like a very interesting focus, people based approach, which blurs the line between like, what is this a music video, is this reality, which is like where I think Floated By, for example, is that line, right?
Yeah,
which is like, what is exactly going on here, and most people are still wondering whether it's a real wedding or not,
right? I mean, that's the reason why I asked you that question, because I would have only to know that from you guys. No, ki acha.
Yeah, so that's that, nice. I think, yeah, that's the perfect like representation of what I think we are trying to do to a degree, you know?
Yeah. I was going to say, in fact, somebody was like recently telling us that they were asked how the girl looks so genuinely happy. She must have been a really good actor.
How do the people look so genuinely?
That was your father who was dancing?
No, that's
focus?
Her mom.
Acha, her mom.
My mom.
Her father
should
is
be
the,
a YouTube star.
Her father is, yeah, you should. Her father is actually on the cover of the record, if you've seen it.
The jovial man in the Hawaiian t-shirt?
Yes.
Jovial to pata nahi, but in that moment,
yes. I'm not sure if the in the background it's the waiter or like some other...
It's
like,
a waiter.
It's a waiter, right? It's like, wo lag raha hai, nahi raha waiter hai. Uske andar matlab ek alag, uski thrill aa rahi hai usko.
It was like a really, that was a very intimate moment in the wedding as well, because we had just started with all the speeches, and there were lots of speeches and like lots of crying and lots of tears, so everybody was like I think very emotional.
Yeah.
And then, you know, that's sort
of, so that, yeah, that's again, you know, it's reality, so it plays into the everything.
But I think that's also something that like Suryakant does, like all of his life is art, even in his music, that's constantly the case, like if he's like even when we'll go, for instance, on holidays, you know, and he hears something, like it's automatically sort of registering in his brain as maybe a sound inspiration. So a lot of that is like, bled into Miya Biwi.
Because
he works all the time, so you know, the only way to hang out with him is to work with him.
Feel like you're reading off your caption that you wrote about your last concert that happened 2 days ago, right?
Yeah. Life is up. No, but it's true, and in a way, like that's how sort of slowly I've started to understand it as well, because I think Suryakant reached that point much earlier on in his life where he saw that, and for me it took a lot of sort of unlearning of, you know, like ideas of like job stability and working in a certain place and having a certain degree, all of which I did very quickly, like in my early 20s, and then, you know, like I was 25 and I was like, okay, life needs to change.
And I learned all the opposite stuff from her, like that. Basically, like, I'm like the Lallu who's like in his early 20s. Achha. Indie rock band in Delhi, right? I mean, that's a terrible job choice.
I know.
You wouldn't suggest
that. Still are, baby.
I know, but like, but you see, that's how the balance plays out. Uh-huh. Like, because obviously, I feel like if I had gone along the way I was going, and I hadn't met her, I would have definitely not found this sort of new educational force in my life, which sort of gave me a new perspective on what I was doing and how to approach it, and then it all balanced.
Make you think about laundry.
Yeah, I mean, whatever. That's basically learning how to like balance the what people call life, personal life, and work.
Right.
For me, that's never been the case. For me, it's all work,
right,
or all this personal life. Like she's saying, there is no boundary between the two, and I mean. But there is some sort, you do need to you need to widen your idea of what your life is. It can't just be work, you know. You don't have to call it work life, but you can understand that your life is bigger than just your work. That's, you know, that's what I'm trying to
say. I mean, I guess you don't think of it as work anymore.
I don't think of it as work, but
one doesn't, not saying one doesn't think of it as work anymore. So then it also sort of is like every day you're waking up and you're just kind of like doing the things. I mean, a lot of the times you're doing the things you like. Obviously, with any kind of work, there's going to be a set of tasks, particularly something like important, I want to say, to young people, because that is something that I've seen with younger people. I mean, it was with us, like with me as well, when I was younger, but we're less like...
Stop me for a second. How old are both of you?
I'm about to turn 34 in 2 weeks.
Okay.
32.
Sweet.
You'll be 33 in like 3 months.
Yeah.
Suryakant likes that like 3 month period where we have a 2 year age gap.
That's right. It's actually nice. I mean, it's sort of like a cool thing because my parents are also like that. They're my mother is 45, my dad is 44. So aise lagta hai ki meri mummy badi hai, matlab hum progressive parivar hai.
That's a nice phrase.
Progressive parivar.
तू भी बना दे पॉडकास्ट कंपनी प्रोग्रेसिव परिवार.
प्रोग्रेसिव परिवार ऐसे ही कर देता हूं आजकल चल रहा है ना. एक इंग्लिश वर्ड, एक हिंदी वाला वर्ड, एक क्लाउड एक डर्ट, बस काम करता हूं. आल्सो वियर्ड क्वेश्चन, बट व्हाट वाज ग्रोइंग अप लाइक? डिड यू बोथ ग्रो अप इन दिल्ली? आई नो यू ग्रो अप इन गुड़गांव, बट व्हाट अबाउट यू?
आई ग्रो अप इन बैंगलोर.
बैंगलोर?
या, इन द 90s. सो आई हैड अ वेरी डिफरेंट अपब्रिंगिंग. I grew up in Bangalore. My family's from Himachal.
Acha.
And I was in Delhi for the first 7 or 8 years, and I was in Bangalore, then back in Simla for 2 years, and then I've been here for half my life.
Matlab like pan state childhood India ke andar jagah jagah pe jana, no sense of belonging.
Your dad was in the government.
Yeah.
Acha.
But he was
Safari suit type ya fir army type kya scene?
He was in the forest department.
Acha, forest department.
Yeah, but in Bangalore he was on deputation, because actually he helped start one of the first NGOs that looked at studying making records of Ayurvedic plants and Ayurvedic medicine in a more formalized way, because that wisdom was sort of
getting lost.
It wasn't getting lost, but it was only within like certain institutions, because there was no academic way of being able to study a medicinal plant and say, okay, ye plant hai, iska ye family hai, this is what it's used. So they kind of did that.
Also, all sort of yoga of herbs and Ayurveda in the Indian context often gets lost in the idea ki ye pseudoscience hai. Usually aisa ho jata hai, because people start looking at it from the very, you know, modern scientific lens.
So I actually had the opposite upbringing. I didn't go to I only went to Ayurvedic doctors and homeopathic doctors.
Till like Hakim Usmani?
No, Ayurvedic doctors study medicine for 7 to 8 years before they're qualified doctors. Like not the MBBS kind of medicine. I mean, they have to do several sort of fundamental courses in that as well. But it's a proper MBBS equivalent that you have to do to become an Ayurvedic doctor.
That is crazy. So when everyone was eating Dispin, you were eating like kada wada pee rahe the or neem.
I was just having bal gutti every day while waking up. So I didn't have headaches and colds or fevers. It's a little immunity pill that my dad
has. I was also like, but my mom was like hooked onto homeopathy.
Aray, yaar, don't.
Naturally.
But that's like, I mean, that's a quack.
It's sugar pills.
Yeah, it's sugar.
Or a smart talking doctor who knows how to prey on
And that's getting popular in America now.
Acha.
Homeopathy. Yeah, it's the most rising, it's one of the fastest growing fields of medicine, obviously. Which is probably because the fucking the price of health and everything is so expensive. But so I mean, for example, I used to have asthma. I also lived in Dubai. And then I used to have asthma. So my
You were like an expat kid?
Yeah, my father was like, we lived in Dubai from 8 to 13.
And then you were in Cyprus before that?
Yeah, I was in Cyprus before that.
Cyprus, Greece?
2 years, yeah. My father was basically in the Merchant Navy.
Okay.
So then once he stopped sailing, then he got like shipping company ka jo bhi ho raha hai. So he worked in Cyprus for 2 years, 2-3 years, then we moved to Dubai, and then he passed away in 2000, and then he shifted back to India. And since then I've been living in India, except for the stint in San Francisco, which is fucking great. But on the medicine topic, I was just saying, like, yeah, I mean, basically, then what happened is, of course, you know, as you grow up, your asthma disappears. That's, you know.
Legit, I also had it. Yes,
yeah, it disappears. Uh-huh. Also, I was in Dubai, so it was dusty all the time. So my mom obviously believed that the homeopathy had fixed the asthma, which is, you know.
Placebo hota hai, Indian hona aur placebo hona, do cheeze ko mila do, super aur ban jati
hai. Yeah, yeah. I believe in placebos, the power of placebo.
Yeah, I believe in placebo, but I think, like, yeah, it is important to
but
have.
I didn't believe in it. I knew it was like a fucking sugar pill.
Of course.
No, but you're talking about, like, you specifically, but I'm saying even the idea that homeopathy is becoming popular, I think it's a healthier step away from, like, for example, America's dependence on, like, popping pills for everything.
Oh, for sure.
Mujhe ghaas se allergy hai. मैं लाइक पिल ले रही हूं
वो तो अलग ही एक्सट्रीम हो गया
मुझे लाइक छींके आ रही है मैं पिल ले रही हूं लाइक दे जस्ट सेड पॉप पिल्स लाइक क्रेजी
सबका सीन ऑफ है
सो इट्स एक्चुअली अ गुड आईडिया
हमारा भी सीन ऑफ है एवरीबॉडी इज वी आर कांस्टेंट
But at least in India, you still have like a fair amount of dependence on ghar ke nuske, ghar ki remedies.
Yeah.
That's still part of everyone's upbringing.
That's
you know, like agar sore throat hai, your mom will not say have a cough syrup. She'll say like pepper or honey khao, ya garam pani piyo, ya
haldi ka doodh hai, jaise ye sab.
I mean, we still sort of very much depend
turmeric
on
turmeric latte.
Yaar. The whole yoga and latte industry in the US and the UK is based on all the shit that the Indians have made.
Turmeric latte.
I mean, wo you wanna, like, it's been exported out of here and now we're suddenly like, oh, like, fuck, that's cool. We should be talking about turmeric too, even though it's existed in our kitchens for 2000 years.
Main USA se wahan pe $4 ka wheatgrass shot pee ke aaya, gluten free wave jo aa rahi thi, maine kaha isko ride karke dekhte hain isme kya maza aayenge. तो मैंने एक लूट वो पिया विड्रा शॉट फिर मैंने पिया फायर शॉट तो इस तरह की तीन चार हेल्थ की चीज़ें कर ली मैंने मम्मी को बोला देखो ये हेल्थ आपके पास क्या है करी बेटा कहते वीट ग्रास की बॉटल तीन साल देने वो जब वो पैकेज करते हैं तो अच्छा लगता है ज़्यादा
वो पैक इट्स ऑल पैकेजिंग एंड ब्रांडिंग एंड मार्केटिंग दे सेल यू दैट शिट It's marketing.
Yes and no.
It's the
yes.
name, it's the color.
No, yes, but there's also obviously so. There's like a seriousness I mean, there's that subculture of like taking that industry seriously. So, for example, with like skincare, for instance, there is a serious subculture where, yes, it's marketing, but they are kind of like giving you ingredients that are very specifically isolated in like what they want to target. That is not just, I mean, there's some science behind it.
I'm very on the edge.
Why? Do you not, like, if you found a better toothbrush would you not prefer that over any random toothbrush
no, I don't know the only thing which can improve in the toothbrush is the engineering of it
so
but,
that's design
but that still
design.
Might not work for your jaws I mean for your teeth
that's not you're arguing about something like getting into specifics
no,
of
I'm just saying
if you have better design or better science behind something
there is some basics which I agree with probably like vitamin C obviously
right
but you know like when it gets into the more
which is great for your skin
which gets into the more like you know like it becomes like washing machines whirlpool quadro atomic oxygen
नहीं तो मैं वो भी कह रही हूँ कि advertising I'm not saying that advertising of all products is good but I'm saying that also being 100% dismissive of the entire like wellness industry is
नहीं I mean
like if they give you a vitamin C serum
yeah.
for example and they say vitamin C serum plus ABZ is this special thing we give you which makes it happen when in fact it's just vitamin C is actually going to do the trick for you So the question
no,
is, how do you measure?
No, but it's not how it is. Like in a serum, for example, if it's vitamin C, they're going to give you vitamin C plus, like, say, ferulic acid, which is an addition to making the vitamin C dissolve faster in your skin. It's not just like vitamin C ke saath kuch bhi dal diya. I'm just saying there's some amount of science.
There is.
There's
a basic baseline.
You can't like fully reject.
But I feel like to beat out each other in the market, they start adding all.
Of course,
so that's the whole point.
But everybody does, like everybody adds a something.
So that's
how
that's,
else are you going to be like different in
well, that's,
7 billion people?
But that's the problem with the whole system, no? That at the end of the day, what happens is, jo wheatgrass ka original shot hi tha, that was always enough. It never needed a blast of like special aloe vera gel.
Basically, ऐसी बात है कि हमें थोड़ी modern science की approval चाहिए होती कि हम जो मम्मी बोल रही हैं वो सही हैं या नहीं हैं.
Yeah, that's the.
That's not what I'm saying.
It's like raw, raw.
That's not what I'm saying.
No, not what you're saying. I'm not. We're doing. We're saying something else. We're basically saying that because they're selling us turmeric latte back to India now in Starbucks, which is.
First of all, yeah.
Which is basically going to be healthy too, to a degree, right?
Right.
Now it will seem more legitimate because, firstly, there will be this sort of whole branding environment which has been created. That's very important.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So that's what they do in the West, which is they really package basic stuff really well, like water and things like that, and they'll sell it to you. And the cost of that thing, the premium of it comes from this understanding that because it's been designed well, because it has this minimal Swiss looking design,
that's
I would take it more
yes.
seriously. Rather than someone who's designed it with ganda curly fonts, even though they might actually be making the better product. So you will never even get around to figuring out how to try out that product.
I think we're talking about just like two different audiences. I think you're saying that you're talking about like capitalism essentially. Yeah. In one way. You're just saying like capitalism is basically.
Yeah, it's
like,
been settling around that for a while.
Yeah.
Yeah, and I'm saying that of course I agree with you, but that having been said, there are discerning customers who do demand sort of certain seriousness in the products that they might buy. And I'm sure that you would also be the same if you sort of like if you were finally buying chappals, jab tune finally khareedi, tune Birkenstock khareedi, right? Because there is better design. You didn't just buy the chappals from like down the
all
road.
All the round chappals would have been great chappals also. Just
no, they're not. Like you did buy, you buy Birkenstock because there is a certain like.
Jute pehne hai. I don't know.
ये तो ऐसी regular वो हैं ये दिल्ली में मेरे जूते नहीं थे एक ही थे तो वो घर से पहन के आ गया सब मुंबई में सामान but I have a very funny story around this idea. मैं I went to Auroville. Auroville has this whole community of you know international community of people living right. वहाँ पे जाके we went to this vegan farm because वहाँ पे only organic food, no meat, whatever. हम लोग वहाँ पहुँचते हैं. So there is this Gora. His name is Gopal. And I'm surprised first of all, Gopal Gora क्या scene है मतलब यहाँ पे अच्छा ये वो वाले गोरे हैं जो यहाँ पे आके इंडिया के हो गए हैं और ये तीन चार ऐसे चीज़ें कर रहे हैं health wellness वाली right. I'm very ignorant in that sense. मैं ऐसे generalize करता हूँ इन सब लोगों को. तो उसके बाद वहाँ पे मेन्यू पे ऐसा लिखा हुआ है राधास कॉन्शियसनेस 50 rupees. राधास कॉन्शियसनेस तो मेरे को भी चाहिए क्या है. तो हम बकायदा लाइन में लगते हैं वहाँ पे इस तरह जैज नियो जैज आउटफिट और इंडियन म्यूजिशियन साथ में बजा रहे हैं इस तरह हम लगते हैं राधास कॉन्शियसनेस के लिए. मैं और मेरे दोस्त राधास कॉन्शियसनेस चखेंगे आज जाके. वो ऐसे स्टील का कनस्तर होता है उसके अंदर उसे खोलते हैं हमको देते हैं हम ग्लास में देखते हैं वो नींबू पानी राधास कॉन्शियसनेस.
That's a great marketing technique.
Because you know the woke Israeli or Britisher looking for the meaning of life on a 1 year trip is gonna be like, ha, yes, I hear.
But most of the world is inauthentic. Like most of the world buys what you sort
this
of.
This is
like
only
sell
100 years
them.
Old, no? This industry.
What this industry?
Advertising. That's the thing. Hmm. Before that, there was no advertising.
Yeah.
So we are also like a product of a very new industry which has transformed people in the way we approach everything in general. Obviously people had to always make stuff and sell it and stuff.
Right.
But advertising I think changed the way we approach buying something, which fundamentally changed everything.
Yeah, I mean if you have good design people want to
buy it. It wasn't capitalism, it was advertising which fucked us, I think.
Which is what? Capitalism, profits.
Are you pro or against capitalism?
I mean, can you be like either or in 2019?
There is, it was always supposed to be a balance between both. That is obviously the case in everything.
I think the problem was that we went like one way too hard or the other way too hard.
Right.
In that way actually, the constitution of India in the beginning was fairly balanced. In some ways, yeah. It was. I mean, of course it had socialist leanings, but it was like fairly balanced.
I mean, it does say socialist, secular, republic.
It obviously had more socialist leanings. Obviously.
No country can say it's a capitalist.
Well, America does, right?
But they don't write in the constitution.
Mm. Yeah, yeah. But I'm saying that like we did have the intentions of trying to have the best of both worlds.
Yeah, we could see what they were fucking up and we made our own kind of fuck up.
Fuck up.
Yeah, talking about your own kind of fuck up. When you made the, what is the video? Where the Money Flows video. And I mean clearly there's the Prime Minister in there, right? Did you receive any flack, any?
Nothing.
Nothing.
I think we were hoping to receive some.
It confused people. I think people were not able to tell.
Huh.
And to be honest, I also wasn't trying to make a point of it. For me, and this is something, I mean, we were trying to figure out what this video means.
Hmm.
Is this video, is it a video based on perspective? Is it a video based on like art? To me, obviously, and I think to both of us, it's one of the most stupidest things ever done in like
the past
century is one of the like, you know, it's like the Chinese sending all the intellectuals to farms.
Mm. Or Tughlaq starting copper coins.
Yeah, I mean, it's like, it was like that. It was like, I'm shifting the capital from Delhi. Aisa scene kar diya usne.
Wo Daulatabad jo Maharashtra mein wahan Delhi ki population ko bhej diya tha.
Yeah.
9 million log mar gaye the.
30. Yeah. And basically, like, so the video was just, it was to be a reminder. It is supposed to be a historical reminder of like, what, I mean, the video itself is philosophical because what it's basically just trying to show is that it's a, the money is a temporary, this idea of you need to make money and stuff is hilarious. You can spend your entire life making crores, trying to game the whole system, and then suddenly one idiot comes on TV and says like, "Acha, tumhare 1000 rupees ke note, which, you know, women have been saving up under beds. Some people had to like, obviously a lot of black money, and then, right. But in general, obviously most of the money in India is not like fucking black money. It's people need this money. It's just money which has to be stored because our system is messed up. Was completely like gone. So we lost so much, and overnight somebody could just make a decision like that, and it didn't matter, and you couldn't fight it. So that is the real lesson, which is what you're fighting for your whole life can just be taken away from you in a moment by someone like so uneducated about it, which is the scary part about it. And it just so happens that it happened, you know, with the BJP or with Modi, obviously. Like, and the video thus doesn't have. In itself, the video doesn't take a stand on whether it was a good or bad thing.
Right.
It just tries to show what has happened. And this happened, obviously, in reality, which makes it more interesting. And that's it. So, there was no ideological stand. It was like a philosophical expose of this fucking happened. And I don't know.
Yeah.
Although, having been said, I would speak... For myself, I'm very much anti the BJP.
Yeah, I mean, that's...
Okay.
There's no like...
Is this the Biwi part of the Miya Biwi, or both Miya and Biwi?
We're both highly...
No, we both, but I would speak for myself, obviously, in this situation.
Okay.
Yeah.
Nah.
Hey, I
would be
hard
to be mad at somebody who's a BJP
supporter. So
I mean, like, I think anti... You know, like, anyone who's pro-BJP is basically scared.
Right.
Or really fucking dumb.
I mean,
at this point, you really, like... Again, I'm speaking about a certain like socio-economic crowd that has population that has access to information.
Mm-hmm.
Obviously, we're not talking about people across the board.
Right.
No, I mean, if you still live in some dream bubble that
that's
like,
exactly,
the BJP,
that's, they do live
will,
in a dream bubble.
Yeah, they really fucking down.
But that's what. But we disagree. Like basically, there. I tend to like. I feel like people go after the BJP because they're scared of a scary future.
Yeah, okay. I have more extreme views. I don't think like we should be making excuses for why people are still unable to understand that we have like a fascist government in place.
Right.
I mean, even if it's not fully fascist yet, it has tried to pull, like in the last 4 years, so many moves that are just shouldn't be okay in a democracy, of course, Kashmir, but like also what's happening in Maharashtra, like doing this sort of like sneaky thing, trying to not have like enough seats and still trying to get your CM in. This is all subversion of democracy. Like,
but
you can't make
hasn't this always been the case when it comes to sort of whatever happens in the Indian political scene? I mean, it's
this
it's
blatant subversion of democracy has never happened before. Of course, the Congress is like fucked up and all of this. Like, nobody's making an argument. See, that's the thing. Like, when somebody's speaking against the BJP, it doesn't automatically become like a But what I'm saying is that just because I'm speaking against the BJP, it doesn't mean I'm trying to make a case to be pro-Congress.
Exactly, yeah.
That's right, not what I'm doing.
That's
And it's always like this whataboutry, right? So if we start talking about the last 4 years, people will say, but what about the 1970s? I don't fucking know, I wasn't born then, right. You know? Yeah. I would have had the same fucking opinion.
I mean, you are a product of your time, you can only speak in that domain.
Exactly, it's not about like what the Congress like didn't do.
I fully agree with her and my view about the government. Like I said, we are figuring out what's wrong with the people. Government to nikamme hain sare, matlab bhare hue hain, but
logon ko
kya hua na log, but that's, I mean, that's where we either harbor like hope for our people or we don't,
right?
And
I guess Kejriwal gives us hope.
Yeah, and I tend to still believe that the majority of Indians are just decent people. They're not like they just don't have time to even be politically inclined, you know?
Right.
That's, politics is like something suffered by poor people, but they're the one, the people who can enjoy like talking about it and thinking about it are people who are well off, because it doesn't affect them.
That's what I'm saying. You know, I mean, that's the reason why, since, you know, the circles that we are a part of, it's very easy and sort of work to talk about injustices, but we also have to realize that our conversations don't penetrate into the minds of the masses. Wo hota hi nahi hai, kyunki wo aadmi hai, wo apna kaam kar raha hai din bhar. उसके सामने जितने पोस्टर आएंगे सेम बंदे की, इज गोना यूज द लॉ ऑफ रेपुटेशन, रिमेंबर, अच्छा ये बंदा है, ये आने वाला है, इसकी मैंने फोटो देखी, इसको वोट करेंगे, वो तो सोचेगा ही नहीं. सो लाइक आई मीन आई थिंक दैट्स वेयर
एजुकेशन ही नहीं
है. एजुकेशन की बात भी, फिर वो आर यू लाइक इन टर्म्स ऑफ लाइक यू नो योर वर्क, व्हाट आर यू ट्राइंग टू केटर टू
मोर एंड मोर पीपल होपफुली विद टाइम. लाइक ऑब्वियसली इट स्टार्टेड वेयर आई पर्सनली स्टार्टेड एंड वेयर शी पर्सनली स्टार्टेड, वेरी डिफरेंट प्लेसेस. लाइक initially she started with news for foreign media, doing highlighting issues in India, and as time has passed she's becoming far more conscious about what she's talking about, how she's talking about it. Because in the news obviously people tend to be very apolitical,
right?
They're supposed to be like, you know, non-opinionated purveyors of like whatever the hell's going on,
or at least that actually used to be.
Yeah, exactly, and that can't be the case anymore because the nature of things. So as time is passing, we are trying to, in our own capacities and hopefully as Miya Biwi, over time, figure out how to break it down, make something which is more and more accessible. It doesn't have to be dumber. That's right. The key word here, you know. We're not going to dumb it down. We're going to find the correct language to communicate these ideas, be it Hindi mein gaane likh rahe ho, be it if you're writing songs about, you know, things we don't talk about, or you're making stories, highlighting issues for Indian people and trying to find a way of, like you said, getting it down lower and lower down the
Accessible, maybe down is
down the economic ladder, you know. And obviously the internet is both pro and bad, good and bad in that sense. The internet will give us the platform to try and get it out.
I mean, it's free, right?
It's free, and also everybody will have access to the internet. Everybody already TikToks eventually, so you know.
And I think, so also then it means that in terms of work, we would hopefully be able to, in our life, to the whole arc of many different kinds of videos, you know, not just like fiction, not just campaigns, maybe documentaries, maybe like a film. We'll see, but then we will continue to sort of experiment with.
We're not an ad production house.
Yes, you're not.
We're not any. Yeah. We're
just trying to make videos.
We are at this point just making films, and like,
right,
whether it comes for like someone we like or like some people have great aesthetics, like maybe Raw Mango, or for bands. Or
I saw hashtag Hashish's video that you made for dance. So we actually, all our friends got high. I was like, you know, I'm going to go interview these guys. You know, let's watch this video. Hum logon ne wo dekha fir, and I was pleasantly distressed, is what I want to say, right? And I asked my friend who's a techno fiend. I was like, bro, kya scene hai? Keh raha hai, bhai, techno videos, hum log techno ke log, hum dark hi sunte hain. Matlab, as a layman to me, that was very interesting, because as the music progresses and goes on, you know, the woman increasingly gets more and more stares and gazes and gazes, and then she breaks out.
Yeah.
So like, wo kya, like, I don't know, I lost my train of thought. Like, what was that like?
That's her brainchild. So
that was one of those, I mean, I guess that's an example of where, like I was saying, when I'm working independently as a director, that's, I guess, one thing that you might have seen.
Okay.
I mean, that's a
it's like what you were talking about. She, you know, it's a topic which is not necessarily like discussed enough, displayed in, you know, mass media.
Or if it's, if it is, it's in the same packaging again and again and in the same manner, right? Yeah. Where it loses its appeal or its, you know, penetration. But you place it in music, and
yeah,
then, and then you have the, you know, subtle sort of internalization of what that issue is.
Yeah.
I mean, that is both good and bad, I guess. So I would say music videos are definitely like, you know how Surakant was saying, like, how do you make it accessible? I think music videos are a great, I don't know, like, would you say genre of film?
A vehicle.
Where you can sort of bring in both serious and non-serious, dreamy and real issues, right? So that's a great medium. Oh, and I forgot the second.
Are you on TikTok?
I have an account now. I've been fascinated by TikTok for a long
time. It's a great, great platform. It is a terrific platform.
People
shit on it all the time. कि ये अभी क्या है ये लोग कुछ भी बना रहे हैं रिक्शे वाले ये सब. I think it's a bunch of BS. It's eventually gonna age up and then, you know, people are gonna get serious about it.
You think so though, or do you think it's just gonna become like a medium like, you know, mainstream Bollywood, which is just like churning out like shit and people are consuming it and then it's.
I mean,
like,
let's say you like, for the lack of a better word, something that is, you know, intellectually stimulating but also relevant to the social political scenario that you are interested in, and you know the books and people you surround yourself with, and you would say main TikTok pe nahi ja sakti kyunki iske upar gand aata hai, but you'd be surprised to find out that actually TikTok also has very solidly produced videos around, say, mental health or fitness, or even like, you know, knowing your language and stuff. What TikTok wins in is this democracy.
Yeah,
it's not so much about ki it's the production quality mein kaun acha hai ya mere type of content kya hai.
That was the article I also read, an article which said, like, which was yesterday I guess, someone was talking about how whatever TikTok is, it's democratized creativity. So people are able to go on it, they can make these interesting videos, you know. It's not like complicated, it's not like a it's not branding itself as a very posh thing, it's branding itself as something for people, for lack of a better way of describing what it is.
But what is the major appeal that TikTok has for the Indian audience? It is that it allows us to be, in one sense, like very emo, no? Like this, we recycle.
Also, you don't use your voice most of the times. So you can just, you know, voice over some other music.
But that's what I'm saying, no? Where does that come from? It comes from like consuming like this Bollywood and seeing these actors be a certain way. We love this, no? We love this, like, acting, singing, dancing. Now, just enabling us to do it to like the scenes we've already seen. I mean, that is the, like, that is the big pull of TikTok. It's I didn't know that there were videos on mental health and all of that, because I always thought it was 15 seconds.
It started as a lip syncing. I mean,
yeah, so
yeah,
it was initially,
and I thought it was
called Musical.ly
like
initially,
Musical.ly,
but then
yeah,
it sort of
Musical.ly was in India based and TikTok is a separate.
No, but it became.
No, TikTok bought Musical.ly,
okay,
and then it integrated.
Yeah.
Parts of it.
So, you know, like in India, TikTok, the way TikTok took off is like what she's talking about. There was a big movement towards this being ability to, people want to be actors, you know, obviously in India, like that
I mean, we like emotions.
We
are a very visceral country.
Yeah, right? We like dancing, acting, singing. These are like the dreams of people.
Yes.
And a way to escape, like, you have the drudgery of everyday life, right?
Yeah.
So you need that. You need to have like entertainment. You can't have, I mean, this constant, like, why is Bollywood still so unrealistic, like mainstream Bollywood? Because you need that. You need to have entertainment that doesn't make you think about like how hard life is in this country, which it is for most people. So yeah, but then there's that like sort of line of does it just reiterate the same bad stuff like again and again?
Very few people get, I mean, very few films I've seen in Bollywood was really, I mean, I you know,
Netflix
young,
is a good way of seeing like where Indian cinema is going.
No, but it's still very
Netflix is becoming mainstream by the day. It is appealing to the scoop poop and BuzzFeed segment.
But they're still making really great content. Like, I mean, Delhi's
Delhi Crime.
Delhi Crime blew me away. The one on the Delhi Crime is the one, right, with the
right.
Lady cop.
That was a great. That was probably
it was a
yes.
really really great show. It's so well written. Okay, but like not done, I guess, technically by an Indian.
I just love how I opened the can of worms when TikTok की बात करी. यहाँ पे तो लोगों ने तैयारी वारी कर रखी है, आर्टिकल वगैरह पढ़ रखे हैं.
I mean, Suryakant really like enjoys TikTok videos. I have a list of, I've seen them through him because he sends me these links on like Facebook Messenger, all the funny ones he's seen.
They're intense, they're weird, you know. They're, a lot of them are really strange, but really I'm very curious. There was a really another funny article, no, like we're just talking about how TikTok is taken off in India, and like it was kind of a bullshit like headline, which is like TikTok is really popular in India by the largely younger male population, which is just getting free, early, cheap internet and is largely unemployed. You know, I mean, it was like, I don't know if you needed to write that, but...
And that's not really true, because actually some of the biggest like TikTok guys, I did this other article that somebody wrote, Poonam Snigdha or whatever name is. She talked about how the biggest star was like, he was a mechanic, I think, he had moved from... somewhere in UP to Bombay, he was working in a garage with his uncle, and now he's like
TikToks.
Yeah, I mean, in a way, it's giving like everybody a way to end.
It's also early reach. No? You start off as like someone on Instagram, and if you're a band or maybe you're a graphic designer, you have a business, right? It's harder to get to that level where you get the recognition. You have to work twice as hard than the
once you get later, right? To join the Instagram or something later, yeah.
Exactly.
But I guess what I'm saying is these things are like double-edged swords, because they are a platform and they are kind of like far more obviously democratic.
Yeah.
But at the same time, it's that algorithm which will just keep feeding you the stuff that you show basic interest in, and then you know you form your own echo chamber. So it's the same thing. Like you, if you're doing like these video like Men Who Cry, that Facebook wala page, which is about TikTok videos of these guys being super emotional.
Right.
Then it's that. That is getting 10 million views and not something important that you want.
What's your relationship with social media, both of you? Because since you are creative, right? There is a constant feedback loop that comes ki maine kuch dala, isne kuch dala, maine dekha, par main apne music pe bhi kaam kar raha hu, film pe bhi kaam kar raha hu. Are you able to separate the two, or is that something that's the constant process?
I don't think I use any social media except Instagram or WhatsApp, I guess. WhatsApp is, for me, just a messenger device.
Right.
Like, Instagram I started using just for work. Like, there was a period where I still, like, posted personal stuff on it, and I think that period's gone. So it's pretty much become, for me, like, my storefront of, you know...
or like an art gallery, right?
It's not even that. For me, it's just engaging high advertising shows coming up. Or like, you know, posting something, saying new music is coming. So for me,
or at holidays.
For me it's because...
Which also feeds the brand of Miya Biwi and...
Yeah, so it's a big like...
meta concept.
Exactly, so it's all feeding.
What a great number we played. We just sell ourselves.
And yeah, I mean, that is what it is. No? They
just sell. That's what people want, right?
Yeah.
In a way.
And it's the easiest thing to sell. Just being honestly, like,
but now we don't have to work on an image, we just take it or leave it. But I think for me, Instagram is still sort of like a gallery of my aesthetics. Like, I will still take photos of things I see or things I want to share.
Right.
For me, it's sort of like, it's also like honestly a photo diary for me, because I scroll back on it often and look at like 2016 May, you know, when I was in Haiti and I was on this work trip. Like, it's a really great photo memory jogger for me. And also when I travel for my news and documentary work, like, I'm going to so many incredible and faraway places in India that I would like to sort of document it. And I mean, just the beauty of things in India, just how people, I think, in outside of cities, I think Indians have a really great aesthetic sense. Like, we generally, like, with clothes or the way we do our homes, you know, they'll come together somehow, even if it's like busy or it's pattern on pattern. It's sort of very looks very nice. So I do like to document it. I remember I got into, like, remember when I was in that phase where I was like documenting windows and doors, because I was going to so many different towns and villages. And I have such a big collection of just how people have like hand painted their windows, doors.
Right.
Everywhere from like Lukla in Nepal, which is the airport that you go to, which is considered the world's most dangerous airport.
Kathmandu?
Yeah, above Kathmandu, it's like where you have to fly to climb up to the base camp of the Everest. From like there to some really small temple town in Kerala, to like a little island off Jorhat, which is a town in Assam. So yeah, for me it's definitely a record. Yeah. So,
but Facebook
to
dala khatam ho gaya.
Facebook nahi aisi baat nahi hai.
Mainly no, I mean for us like.
Haan,
I literally use it as some like feed for dumb shit or like funny things. Yeah. But in terms of communicating with people or sharing anything publicly, it's
right.
I'd never post anything on it.
Yeah, I mean, each of these things are so exhausting. I think that unless like your job depended on it,
right.
Like people tend to choose one thing. Like journalists tend to be on Twitter, and I fucking hate Twitter. It is definitely, in my opinion, the worst social media.
Why is that?
Because there's just way too much hate on. I mean, it started being a more sort of like maybe smarter space because it was.
140 characters, so you have to be clever and precise.
Yeah, and it was, you know, opinions of people and sharing information. So for example, Instagram became a more visual space, so sort of invited more people with perhaps more, I don't know,
creative aesthetic leaning.
Visual narratives, whereas like, you know, Twitter brought.
If you know how to speak, and write, welcome to Twitter.
Yeah, but then it sort of like very quickly became this
literacy,
like
basically literacy
shit
said past
show
time.
Of
yeah.
Just like hate and trolling. Like I'm not on Twitter. I only go on Twitter to post things I've done so that if somebody had to Google like Surabhi Tandon video journalist, there's like a place
where I have all my stories. That's how I was able to sort of understand your.
Yeah, it's just like work, right? It's just like. A smart way to put your, because I only put my work there, which is like the most serious also. It's just like, okay, this is like alternate website which people can do. But like with Kashmir, for instance, which is the first time I probably did a story which had a far bigger audience than just in France, for instance, who are watching, like people watching France 24, the odd people, Indian watching France 24 in India. And like immediately, like I'm nobody, right? Like I have. Nobody's, and in the sense that, like, of course, my story is being watched, but like, as a journalist, I'm of no influence at all. And like, straight up, people will get on your Twitter page, they will send you rape threats if you're a woman, and you hear about it. Like, I've obviously heard about it constantly from like my female colleagues, and you're like, that sounds disturbing, but until you get one, you don't actually realize like how, even if it's just words coming from a random stranger, douchebag, who you can like report, block, all of that, once you've heard those words said to you, like it is disturbing and it's so unnecessary, and it happens so much more on Twitter than it does, at least in my experience.
I mean, yeah, didn't you have that Instagram post where I think you had a story where the guy sort of disguises himself with a mask and speaks about how, you know, he was
pellet guns,
right? Right, and then I was reading through the comments and people were supportive, but there was also like people who were like passionate about, you know, obviously the right wing of India.
Yeah.
And then hating on, and then that was interesting to see how people.
And on that also, like some people I just straight up blocked because I don't have the patience of like having somebody like constantly just say things that are not true. You know, like you can clearly see what's happening there. And it's like, this is not true. This journalist is lying. This person is like not been hit by pellets. What the fuck are you looking at if you're like commenting and saying that? You know, like what do you think?
I mean, some people are just straight up like.
Yeah, and
like,
I don't have the patience or the time for this. So it's like.
But like, do you just? I know that you are like anti fake news, you know, vigilante, at least based on whatever I saw on Twitter. Do you both collectively get hate or not? No hate whatsoever. It's all chill.
That Kashmir thing got me some hate,
that's it.
Suryakant only gets love.
I mean, of course. I mean, you're clearly in the hearts of every girl.
No, let me sometimes there'll be the occasional, bro, I love your music, but I don't agree with you, but I love you anyway. It's just like, I don't agree with your politics, but I love you, man. So, gaane likh. I mean, it's a funny, like, I mean, music is a funny thing because it actually, like, it's a uniting thing generally, I think. It's not, you know,
right.
Two people who don't necessarily agree with each other might still like the same song.
And I think with music, if you don't like something, you're not going to send an email to the artist being like, I didn't like what you did. You just won't say
it. It's like you're
say.
Taking 2 minutes out of your day to write ki mere ko ye pasand nahi aaya.
That way, my favorite social media is YouTube comments.
Oh, that is crazy. Especially the India versus Pakistan comments who start forever.
Yeah, I mean, there, you know, I mean, I think most people look at negative. I think like it's the great collective humor which comes out.
Yes.
In YouTube, where people, you know, and you can always the comments on certain songs or videos where somebody's noticed something and you can see like thousands of people have agreed and found it.
Yes, because they've liked it and he's like, maze lene hai, toh wo time duration bhi de raha hun. Haan, jaake wo wale maze le hote hai,
yeah.
I think that's also great. Like YouTube comments are a great space to see how people from all over the world connect on something that like
it's like BBC
is not,
and
yeah, people. Within your local context, you know, it's like. That's funny universally.
Other than Facebook, you know, like I think, and Twitter.
Mm.
I mean, I don't think Twitter's, I think Twitter's still trying to fix it. Shit. Twitter's ridiculous. I mean, obviously, you have Donald Trump. You can't block. I mean, they're in a funny situation because they obviously have a president that, of America who just lies all the time. And they can't like block him because at the same time, it's like he's the fucking president of the United States of America.
USA company,
like,
company is bad for them. USA company is bad for them.
No, he won't do anything.
He's
done. I mean, look, if he really wanted to, they would have to shut. They could shut him down, but you know, like. It's a very weird place, but unlike, you know, unlike whatever Facebook, Twitter ka jo CEO, at least he's taken a stand.
Right.
You know, he doesn't agree. He is going against like political advertising. He's not allowing it on his platform. And unlike that, Facebook is going straight ahead with jhoot bola bolo. Let people decide.
Hmm.
So for me, like it's become clear that like that 33-year-old dude, Mark Zuckerberg, sorry, is essentially one of the most dangerous people alive because he controls a platform where almost 2 billion people communicate with each other.
Right.
And he won't take a stand.
He won't take responsibility for it. You know, even if he has a political stand.
Right.
You know, whatever, fine, have a political stand. But take responsibility for owning something which impacts 2 billion people's lives. You can't pretend like it doesn't. And he does that exactly. So that's, for me, Facebook is the most dangerous thing alive. Like, more than Twitter, more than, like, anything else. It's Facebook, and that shit needs to... And it ain't going away, going anywhere.
Also, family WhatsApp groups need to end.
Actually, Twitter was trying to come up with this thing, that now you can only make a limited number of groups, with limited number of people in it. They don't want to have this, like... They did that WhatsApp forward cut system they're trying to fix.
But that's like political, like again to combat fake news.
Yeah.
I'm talking about family WhatsApp groups. It's like that horrible position where like if you leave it, you're so rude and the black sheep of the family.
So it's better
but
to start
if you're
off with
in
black
it, you're just going to end up hating the family. That's what I said. I told my mom, I was like, listen, I'm just going to dislike you guys more if I'm on this group. So let me leave it. Otherwise, I'd just be like, that's another stupid forward, guys.
जैसे मेरी मम्मा क्या कहती है ये एक बेटा ये एक हेल्थ इन्फ्लुएंसर है इसको मैं फॉलो करती हूँ ये एडवाइस देता है मैं कहा यार मैं ये सब पढ़ता रहता हूँ मैं क्यों खोलूंगा आपकी पोस्ट उस पर व्हाट्सएप पे पोस्ट आई हुई है एक फेसबुक की लिंक है जिसके ऊपर मैं कुछ खोलूंगा फिर एक वीडियो खुलेगा मैं देखूंगा अच्छा और ऐसे अंकल भेजते रहते हैं रैंडम जैसे
उनको पता ही नहीं है
मतलब कि एक तो इंडियंस को शौक इस चीज का होता है सेल्फ अवेयर एक अवेयरनेस चलाने का दोस्तों मैं इलाहाबाद के अंदर बैठा हूँ और ना मेरा नाम फलाना फलाना है आज ये हो गया है तो दोस्तों मैं ये बात करना चाहता हूँ आप लोगों से कि ना जो भी हमारे देश में हो रहा है ये अच्छा नहीं हो रहा है ज्यादा शेयर करें सब्सक्राइब करें और वो सारे बड़े लोग एक दूसरे को फॉरवर्ड करते रहते हैं वही उनका ज्ञान बन जाता है
I think it's symptomatic though of like the kind of community living and my
We are a collective country by
Yeah,
default.
So we like that, you know, like WhatsApp, like I found when I used to be part of that group, for example, my mom's family group, like it's four sisters and two brothers. वो रोज सुबह उठके गुड मॉर्निंग
क्या है गुड मॉर्निंग
या बट इट वाज लाइक बट आई रियलाइज द थिंग इज दैट दे वर जस्ट सो यूज्ड टू लाइक ग्रोइंग अप फॉर सो मेनी इयर्स टुगेदर दैट इट वाज सो ग्रेट फॉर देम इन द मॉर्निंग लाइक नाउ पोस्ट रिटायरमेंट टू लाइक टच बेस विद योर सिस्टर्स एंड ब्रदर एवरी मॉर्निंग यू नो ब्रदर्स एवरी मॉर्निंग Like it's just that it's that simple thinking ki hum hi bol sakte hain sabko subah subah you know?
Joint family system you know?
Yeah.
In WhatsApp
they should Which have is like app, WhatsApp family sabko sunna padega ye
nahi aur uske baad fir jo flex board banate hain unko naya dhanda khol dena chahiye good morning ke text ki image banane ka uske paise le lete
hain I'm sure there are people making good morning memes by the way I'm sure that's happening
I mean that's
big business thing
next
Miya Biwi product line mein
I mean,
good morning.
So like let's do like a fun rapid fire of sorts. I haven't thought of any rapid fire. So I'll ask you.
Rapid fire questions.
Okay. Yeah, rapid fire questions. Hai.
Just throw those questions back.
ठीक है, जो मन में आएगा, ठीक है? Delhi, Mumbai.
Delhi.
Bombay.
You said Bombay.
Like, I don't like the word Mumbai.
अरे ठीक है, what the best? Mumbai. Anyway.
कोई philosophical वो नहीं था.
नहीं, हर चीज से मैं ऐसे एक्सट्रैक्ट नहीं कर रहा वैल्यू की प्रोफंडिटी ऐसे भेज नहीं रहा, नॉर्मल इंसानों वाली. म्यूजिक या फिल्म?
म्यूजिक.
या म्यूजिक.
म्यूजिक
ग्रेट. वी स्टार्टेड फिल्म प्रोडक्शन हाउस. बहुत
सर, हमारे तो म्यूजिशियन भी.
कॉन्स्टेंटली ट्रैवलिंग या बीइंग एट होम?
कॉन्स्टेंटली ट्रैवलिंग. दैट्स
बिकॉज़ यू थकान है. हां, काफी थकान है क्या?
नहीं, आई जस्ट, आई हैव ऑलवेज बीन अ होम बॉय.
होम बॉय.
होम बॉय.
एंड आई एम मोर अप, या द ऑपोजिट.
ओके. यार और क्या कोई चीजें होती हैं करण जोहर टाइप के लोग क्या पूछते हैं? आई हैव नो आइडिया. आई जस्ट वांटेड टू एंड द सेकंड सीजन. हां, ऐसे क्या पुरानी बॉलीवुड मूवीज एकदम ऐसे मुगल-ए-आज़म टाइप की, या फिर न्यू एज फ्रेंच कंटेंपरेरी जो सीन जो भी कुछ होता है
ऐसा कोई? It's always on a film to film basis.
Yeah. Yeah. But generally, we are definitely a like
romantic like shit.
Yeah, like nostalgia.
Romantic.
Like
nostalgia.
In the beginning, a lot of, remember, like in the beginning when we had just started dating, I think something that we both enjoyed very quickly and recognized with it was that we like old
Hindi music,
old things, nostalgia. Old,
तीन कोई फेवरेट या एक कोई ऐसी किताब जिसने जिंदगी का परिवर्तन कर दिया जबरदस्त तरीके से?
एक ऐसी किताब
या तीन
साइंस फिक, आई डोंट नो, नॉट, आई मीन आई आई रीड लॉट ऑफ साइंस फिक्शन व्हिच फंडामेंटली राइटिंग
एचजी वेल्स सॉर्ट ऑफ स्टफ.
या एक्चुअली लाइक स्टफ लाइक दैट, बट देयर वाज लॉट ऑफ
द वन दैट दैट सॉर्ट ऑफ चेंज्ड द वे यू सी द वर्ल्ड.
देयर इज नो वन, देयर वाज अ, इट वाज अ बुक कॉल्ड द साइंस फिक्शन आर्गसी,
हां,
व्हिच वाज लाइक अ कलेक्शन ऑफ शॉर्ट स्टोरीज. व्हेन आई रीड ऑल ऑफ देम आई रियली लर्नड अ लॉट. It's like watching Star Trek for me, which changed my life. More than anything else.
Star Trek?
Yeah.
After seeing Captain Spock and his big ears?
All of Star Trek for like...
Suryakant gets his relationship lessons from Star Trek.
I got my entire like philosophy of morality, of being optimistic for the future of humanity, of like what is kindness, all this stuff from Star Trek, not from people.
That's so interesting.
Yeah, because it's the only show in the, I think, the history of like human civilization which was forward thinking to the point that it dreamt of where humanity will be, will, should be, or could be. Everything else has always been like not too far, or like some dystopia or realistic, right. But that was just like a collective. I mean, there are a lot of problems with it. There are no brown people in it, so I guess we all killed each other. But like, in general, like, it was always really forward thinking, and it dealt with issues which I think, you know, which you always have to ask questions about.
And what about you?
I mean, I guess if I had to pick a genre, I would say like magical realism, because it's like the Bollywood equivalent.
Murakami, are we heading that way to it?
Yeah, Murakami or Marquez or John F. Peterson. I mean, that's like the like kind of in one way it's an escape of reality. So because I think when I was at least like in my college years, a lot of it was spent reading lots of academic books and research papers and things, so this was a good sort of escape. And it's not, they're not, these books are not like as cheesy and as emotional as other dramas or fiction, right. Books. And then it kind of also gave in a weird way this voice to my dreams, which are like very similar within the realm of magical realism. So there's like a plot which seems very realistic, and then sort of, you know, like, so say it's a plot about a nun who's holding a, what do you say, sermon. That's the dream. It seems like very realistic, but then the nun actually eats heads.
Lovely.
In elevators. Yeah.
Wow.
Pleasant, pleasant stuff. But I mean, in the sense that it's, yeah, I would say it's the language of mine. The language of.
To sum up, she gets really fucked up. Okay.
I mean, the psyche is a fucked up place, yeah. Right? That's why people are afraid of. You know, writing down their dreams. कि मेरे को ऐसा dream आया. अच्छा, ये सपने होते हैं. ऐसे people dismiss it. To sort of start closing things off. What is one thing that, you know, sort of people don't know about the both of you? Like the best kept secret or something exclusive for this show that you would... Sorry.
I mean, if it's a secret, why would we reveal it?
I mean, I know. I just like, this is the part where I transitioned into a Zoom TV reporter. When I met the scoop type scoop type scene.
There's a foot difference in our height.
Acha. What are you? How tall are you?
6'2".
You're like the perfect groom for the classifieds column in India.
6'2". Indie rock musician out of Delhi.
Tall, dark, handsome. Jo hota hai na. Cast no bar. Ladka working in good MNC.
MNC
card ke
bill. Cast no bar, profession no bar.
Business.
You'll have to fit into that category.
Looking for fair, beautiful wife. I don't know, I was very interested. Secretly, Suryakant's very conservative. He's like, yeah. SC BB. Yeah. No, I'm a
dude. Do
Lunga.
I'm a like, yeah, I'm very conservative. That's the secret.
Yeah, basically old-fashioned, that's the thing. It's not like, hey, let's have, like, I don't know.
They have a fancy word for it nowadays. Purists. It's called classical liberal, so apparently that's what everyone
says. No, I would say we're more purists.
Of what?
Balanced, I don't know. It's crazy, nahi hai, basically. We're not, yeah, exactly. We're not like...
Matlab sadgi ka jeevan.
Practical, we're practical, I think.
Practically creative.
We know what we've taken on in life and we're trying to practically go about it. It's not like...
Yeah.
10 shots of heroin in the morning. Right.
Bro, that dream that was sold to us by the 70s rockers is dead.
That's interesting. I always said that. Anna?
Yeah, you were talking about it.
I always said that we were all like, we were all got screwed over because we all saw these like Jim Morrison and Jimi Hendrix and we thought, wow, kitne cool ho gaye.
You are preaching to the hand, Chun.
And essentially, they were basically like, they just got dead by 27, did a bunch of drugs.
27 club ka mere room mein poster tha itna bada. Aise lines mein bakaayda abhi us time pe postergalley.com website aayi thi. Custom banwaya ki ye 27 club hai. Ismein Joplin hai, Morrison hai, ye hai. Uski pooja karta tha har roz about ke. Sid Barrett ki photo ki. Uske haath mein se acid ka blotter hai is tarah se. Yaar ye
kaha. Wo to lekin late mara.
Wo late mara. 70s. But wo jo ek self-sabotage ka idea tha na ki sex karo, drugs karo, rock and roll karo. Ye jindagi hoti hai, abhi jeena hai. वो किसी तरह से 13-14 साल के इंडियन बच्चों को मिल गया गलती से।
It's a very stupid idea. If they, you know, like, yeah, it's just the wrong idols.
I mean, in that like time and context, like they stood for like
coolness.
A very fast-paced social revolution, right? So obviously now, yeah, like 40 years later, we're like, well, that's kind of stupid doing heroin.
Yeah,
or like doing cocaine every day or smoking when you were pregnant.
Huh?
That's so smart.
Yeah, I mean, it is wasted.
We didn't know that.
Yeah, we're in the eco-friendly, sustainable, you know, woke, wellness. Hamara scene aisa. We want sustained creatives. We want our people to live and like, inse baat kar pao, right? Not like, ye 27 pe mar gaya. Achha, chalo, jaake eulogy
wagera. 27 is so young also.
No, but that's what I was going to say. That ab wo 27 itna kam lagta hai. But actually, by then, you were having kids or you were sort of like, you, of course, do like, even our parents' generation, they were accelerated adults by like 25, 27.
Yeah.
They're having... Your families by...
Yeah, but abhi bhi to 27 years old. Kurt Cobain was 90s mein tha, Amy Winehouse bhi tumhare.
That's still 30 years old.
Yeah.
1990 was
still
30 years old.
I mean, but you know. Anyway, basically we were so the wrong idols. You know, we needed the like, achha 70 saal ka bhi jee raha hai, art bana raha hai, he's still like...
You were also sold like Paul McCartney, jo hai...
Yeah, but no one sold us Paul McCartney, like they sold us like...
Jim Morrison.
Yeah, you see, they sold us the hedonistic guy. They didn't sell us like... Paul McCartney.
But do you think that when musicians decide to be full-time, make music a full-time career, they look at...
Because they were never musicians.
Or they... Exactly. I'm saying people who want to...
Yeah, they do.
Take music
I took
very
on,
seriously.
I started a music... A big part of me taking up music are these people. But...
No, but one of like the most...
I think that's very key, that they are the sort of gateway into
they
this.
Are the gateway and then, you know, like you realize that, okay, Jim Morrison was... A really interesting human being, but
not a life I ever wanted to replicate.
Gateway was like Jeff Mann.
No, he was my gateway to
the
like,
kind of music.
Yeah, to like how to go about making something beautiful, doing it yourself. It was a gateway.
I guess I see it like now that I'm thinking about it, I see it differently because maybe it's a woman looking at these idols who are men, so it's not, you never look at it as something
right.
you want to be, but the ideas that they represent of like sexual freedom or more openness to
fuck authority,
substances,
all of those things, you know.
No, I don't mean the sort of like rebellious, like
anti-establishment.
Yeah, I don't mean the anti-establishment bit that was there, but like that will, that's become the stereotype. I'm saying the larger, like more philosophical ideas. It is the first time when like there was a much larger rollout of feminism, of like sexual revolution, because women had suddenly had responsibility, I mean could take on the responsibility of being promiscuous and not having sex. So even
right.
like substances, like a lot of amazing art was created through, like, drugs.
I mean, of course, psychedelic is my most searched Google term of 2013-2014. I was trying to become that.
Psychedelic band.
Psychedelic band, nahi, psychedelic music. Kya hai psychedelic? Psychedelic, ye bhi psychedelic, wo bhi psychedelic, bas.
I've actually never used the term psychedelic in like...
I've always tried to figure out what that means.
Yeah.
And I realize psychedelic simply means introspective, philosophical. That's it. People who are you want to concern yourself with the world of inner world. That's all. It's not some, you know.
Right. I mean, the I guess the dumber version of that is trippy.
trip kar raha hu.
Trip.
But I mean, the trip is a correct word also, no? That's why the word stuck. It's actually
right.
the precisely correct word to describe your experience when you are enjoying something deeply.
Adventure.
Right.
It exactly. It is like a journey and experience.
So talking about this this great conversation, which I enjoyed deeply, पता नहीं था कि हम ऐसे हिंदी must standings पे जाएंगे. I generally had fun. What is one thing that you have the mic? Like, what is one thing that you would want to say to people who are listening? Again, you know, young creatives, young people. या फिर जो भी कोई सुन रहा है, क्या एक ऐसी बात है जो मियां बीवी को बोलनी है, या क्या सूर्यकांत को बोलनी है, या सुरभि को बोलनी है साथ में? क्या
you go first, of course.
Oh, thanks. I would say, and it's sort of a summary of maybe a theme that we've like touched upon in this conversation, which is that I've learned in my life that instead of trying to be creative in a way that you think is creative, that other people will consider creative, you should try to figure out what is the best way to express how you perceive the world. And that takes more maybe focus on figuring out yourself rather than
following the next new trending thing.
Following the new trending thing or constantly like saying ki mujhe ye bhi pata hona chahiye, mujhe ye bhi pata hona chahiye. Maybe sort of figure out like
the
is
space.
Situation mein ya is context mein ya in kapdon mein mujhe kya pasand hai, what, you know. And that I think is a process that comes and becomes far easier with age. Like in my 30s, it has been far easier for me to accept who I am, what I think, what I say. So just like give it time and like
cool.
Yeah. Let it come to
me. I think you should just you should hone in understanding your instinct. You should figure out when it's speaking to you and like listen to it. And actually, the hardest part is figuring out what is instinct. And instinct is basically in my, you know, I'd be sitting there. If I wrote something, I can only speak in a musical sense. I wrote something and I had a feeling. That feeling is instinct. So you can't forget that you had. So, you know, if let's say you wrote a song or you made something and you forgot about it 30 years, like a month later. What you have to do is, and you want to reconstruct it, what you have to do is go about trying to, you don't forget that you had that feeling and you try to reconstruct that moment is all you do. And so you have to learn how to listen to yourself, what you are telling yourself, be it in an edit or like a piece of music or mixing music. It's always there, something's telling you, you just have to kind of figure out what it is. I don't know, it's really weird, an abstract sort of thing too, but...
I mean, what your gut is saying.
Yeah, right? I mean, just figuring out when your gut is even speaking to you, you know, like, is a really weird skill to develop. But that is, some people, I think people who got really successful and... or not necessarily became good at what they do in the way that they wanted to do it, basically figured out how to listen to their gut. And just started saying, fuck you to everybody else.
Right.
Well, not all the time.
As you can see, we're a very me inside, like me couple.
Clearly.
Think about what is inside your heart and mind.
Yeah, I mean.
I mean, that's important. Mm-hmm. I think that
you have to answer your gut, and then you like you translate it into reality, and then you're trying to balance like.
Right.
And then when you have two people who are doing that, you can imagine how much we're fighting about whose gut or instinct.
Yeah. So but always, like you might have a cleaner gut than him because you eat the healthy shit. So.
But always.
True. I do take spirulina.
But also, I think if you work in a team. Fucking drop the ego and like always just figure out how to make the best end product of what it is. Even if in that moment you might believe in something, but if you like somebody says something to you and there's a moment where you doubt yourself and you think, okay, that's a good idea. Even if you've done it 2 years, you've developed your own idea, you know, and you're like, ah, third year we're gonna do it. And then somebody comes up to you and like, let's do this instead.
Yeah.
It's okay to like fucking drop it. Even if it's been 2 years worth of work. It's completely okay.
That having been said,
and I've done
it's
that
not before. So easy to...
No, I mean, but
because you're invested in it personally and emotionally.
Yeah, but that's right? Why you should never like get so invested in that you forget. Because at the end of the day, if you've done something for 2 years and anyway, it's not exactly come out that great, then it's even, it's not a, you know, like, but if you can figure that out, I think that's good.
Fantastic. Where can people find you on socials?
Socials?
Yes.
Instagram.
Miya.bb on Instagram.
Me, okay.
That's it.
Miya.bb on Instagram. Cool.
Yeah, we're choosing one social medium.
Fantastic. Miya.bb it is. It has been an absolute pleasure, Suryakant and Surabhi, to aap logo se baat karke, aapke samaksh ye ideas rakke aur aap logo ke ek is tarah ke roop ko dekke aapke ghar mein aapke boxers aur sweater ke saath aur matlab
at least like shorts to pehne. We have these huge fights at home where it's like if I can't hang out in my underwear, you can't hang out in your underwear. It's only fair, right?
Absolutely.
I mean, I have a...
It's a
that fight didn't
get... It's a man's world, what can you say?
It's a man's!